everybody. This is Christopher with AG Productions. Welcome to another edition of First Impressions. GW's got two brand new offerings from the Caradron Overlord line this week. Let's have a look at them and see what we think. The first offering is called the Grunstock Thunderers, and the best impression of this that I can give you is that it's essentially the Dwarven Age of Sigmar version of a Space Marine Devastator squad. Essentially what this is five guys set up with some very, very heavy weaponry, each one of them carrying a different weapon into battle. This is a pretty simplistic kit as far as its appearance goes, looking very similar in style as far as the models to the, the Arcanaut Company that we saw last week. However, each one of these weapons that these guys are carrying is so unique and so cool that this whole set brings a new level of awesomeness into the Caradron Overlord line. Not to mention that one of the guys has a metal parrot on his shoulder. Let's, you know, just throw that into the mix just for fun. Very, very cool looking kit. Again, great looking addition to this new Caradron Overlord line. So far, I've not seen anything within this line that makes me go, ooh, that really doesn't work. Very, very neat set. Little pricey compared to the previous unit kit that we talked about, the Arcanaut Company. This one coming in at £25 for five miniatures versus £27.50 for 10 miniatures. So almost, when you think about it, miniature for miniature, it's almost double the price. So you're looking at probably, once this converts into US dollars, when it gets put up on the US website, you're probably looking at a $45 kit for five miniatures. So about $9 per model. Definitely a much more expensive kit, but again, very, very cool models and something you should probably check out if this kind of stuff has been interesting you since they started releasing it last week. Next item on the block, and the final item on the block for the day, is the Grunstock Gun Hauler. Now, I have to start this whole thing off, I suppose, wondering to myself why these two kits are called Grunstock instead of Arcanaut Thunderers and the Arcanaut Gun Hauler. Are they going to be changing the nomenclature for the other stuff as well? I don't know. Maybe it's a different faction within this Caradron Overlord stuff. No idea. But I do find it odd that both of today's offerings are under this name of Grunstock as opposed to Arcanaut like last week. Anyway, I suppose it doesn't matter. The Grunstock Gun Hauler is what appears to be a smaller version of the kit that we saw last week, the Arcanaut Frigate. For those of you that have been in Warhammer long enough, or 40K long enough, think Eldar or Dark Eldar Ravager versus Raider. It seems to be essentially the same type of thing, where you have a very similar looking item. One is much larger than the other, though. This is a single balloon dirigible that has two riders in it, as opposed to the three or four, I don't remember which one, the Arcanaut Frigate had. But again, much smaller kit, single cannon on this thing. But what I really like about this one are little bombs on the side. It's got what appear to be five or six bombs on each side of the cockpit area. And I don't know if those are bombs that could be dropped off the side, or based upon their placement, it almost looks like they're within reach of the gunner, and that's actually the ammunition that gets loaded into this gigantic gun that's mounted on the front of the front of the gun hauler vehicle here. Now, one of the things that I do find interesting, and they do not have a long distance shot of this so that you can see it in this arrangement, is there is a secondary weapon on this thing. If you don't want this large mouth cannon, you have the option of what appears to be a much smaller drill. Now, I don't know why you would equip what would obviously be a very close combat weapon on a flying vehicle, but it's a neat little idea to have a secondary option on this thing. The whole thing is just darn cool. I mean, much like the Arcanaut Frigate of last week, it's just a neat item. One of the things I really like about this one that I don't recall seeing on the Arcanaut Frigate is hanging under this thing is an anchor. And I see a lot of modeling opportunities here when I first saw this for maybe cutting the anchor off and, you know, gluing it to the base of the miniature and then sort of modeling a chain going all the way up into the Arkanaut, or not the Arkanaut figure, going up into the Grunstock ground hauler, or gun hauler, so that it looks like it's actually anchored to the ground so it's not going to float away. But again, that would require some serious modeling, but I think it would be a unique addition to any army. Very, very cool stuff again this week coming out of GW. Quite impressed, and I hope that you guys are as well, and I hope that you guys are enjoying these first impression videos. If you have any comments or questions, please feel free to leave those in the comment section down below. Also, be sure to leave a thumbs up on this video and subscribe to AG Productions if you haven't done so already. Again, I want to thank you very, very much for watching. God bless you all. Have an awesome rest of the day, and I will see you all in the next video.